Alright, welcome back to Turok. Last time we fought dinosaurs and grabbed keys. This time we're gonna fight more dinosaurs and people and hopefully grab more keys. I may have different health than last time because I had to... I had to restart from my save point instead of that checkpoint, which kinda sucked. But I had no problem just running back. And I realized that in the first video, my graphics weren't as clean as I was hoping. So I upped my bitrate, but at the same time I'm noticing a little bit of slowdown in my game after that. So I guess I just don't have the processing power in terms of a computer to maximize everything. So someday, when I have a couple thousand extra dollars to burn, I will upgrade some stuff. Like, my computer's okay. Overall, like, it can record Darkest Dungeon and shit just fine. But the problem is my processor. My processor just doesn't have enough power anymore, and the graphics card I bought can't run at full capacity because of my motherboard. Like, my motherboard's pretty fucking old. That's the problem with my entire computer. Not that my computer's bad. I'm very thankful to have it, but having the lowered capabilities, like, even if I upgrade stuff, it's not gonna be strong enough because the motherboard's like 6 years old at this point. So to do any meaningful upgrades, I'd have to just buy a new one, which isn't that much money, but I don't know how to install a motherboard. So I'd have to have some friends help me, or maybe a YouTube tutorial or something, but it's still pretty scary to get a new motherboard processor. That's usually like the bulk of the computer anyway. So I might as well at this point just rip out my hard drive, my graphics card, and then just redo everything. Just get a new one from scratch and just move all that shit. But otherwise, I just I just edited the first video of this, and I took about a half-hour break after that. Fuck me. Oh, shit. And when I was watching it, I was like, okay, there are some graphical things happening. So that's why I kind of came back to this. I'm trying to maximize what I'm doing. But just on the run here, from what I was doing, everything ran really smooth. And then when I started recording, I'm starting to slow down just a little bit. Not like a huge amount, but definitely something noticeable. So that's just kind of tipped me off that I need to increase my computer's capacity. It's just for this game, though. Like I said, I have no problem running Darkest Dungeon. Like, I can record, run that at full settings just fine. But for some reason, it's this game. I think it's because the graphics are pretty nice. No! I wasn't done up there! Shit! Oh well. Looks like that was it. Hopefully, I didn't look around too much more past that. I'm hoping. I don't know, like, I see stuff. Eh, whatever. Hopefully we can backtrack or something. I don't know. And then my window's open, so you may hear my blinds rustling around. It's kind of windy outside. It's been storming the last couple days, but it's been really hot in my room from the computer's heat. The reflections always trip me out. Oh man, I love the freedom in this game. Like, things that you feel like you shouldn't be able to do, you're able to do by just jumping and cutting and stuff like that. It just makes the game a lot more fun. Ooh, fucking bubbles? Is that part of the HD? Is that the new HD remake stuff happening right there? We get bubbles? Alright, I'm not gonna even fuck with that. There we go. I also like that they put the coins there just to kind of lead you by jumping, kind of thing. Is there a portal up there? That I'm not seeing? Is there more stuff happening? Are there more mysteries abound? I could see myself, just like Darkest Dungeon, I could see myself playing this when I have, like, more free time or whatever. And I don't feel like recording or whatever, doing that stuff. Oh, all keys found, good. Like, I could see myself just booting up a new file for this and just running around for, you know, like a half hour. Just for the fun of it. Wait. Oh, is this level 2 now? Because I remember that. Shit! No! No! Oh, I think I wrecked myself. Alright, I'll run back. The good part is we get to see what the hell's over here now, besides bullets. There's this. I don't know if I can actually make that jump. Yeah, there's no way. So hopefully we get some, like, space jump boots or something at some point, and we can just double jump our happy ass across there. Make that. I think we were pretty close to this. Let's pick up from here. It took about 4 minutes to run here. Thankfully, I was able to skip a lot of stuff. Okay. So there's that teleport pad that I don't know what to do with, because I can't get there, so let's just jump down. Very thankful for no fall damage. And now we are back in the thick of things. Oh, we have to go back through this shit? Damn it. Oh well. There were far less enemies this time too, which was really nice. Is there anything here? Oh, see, we can check around now. The stuff that we missed. I'm looking for a portal or something down here. Like some items. Nothing? You're telling me that there's nothing down here. There's a big health we don't need. Okay. At least we explored it. That don't feel as bad, because when I ran through here too, I went, man, there's probably something here that I missed. We don't have to deal with it now. Dog, please. Dog. I think my mic's catching that too. Yeah, like I was saying before, I gotta wash my dogs or something after this. Okay, so we got this. Oh, it takes us here. What did this... We've been through there, I think. Okay, there it is. And I stepped on that by accident. Oh, shit. Oh, shit, he shoots! He scores! Your fucking fireballs? What are you? Shells. Thank you for informing me. This place is spooky. Right, a lot of health in case you got torn up coming through here. I feel like this game would be harder if you had the controller. The mouse and keyboard just makes you a little too fast. Like, the game was designed and balanced around a controller. And then you're not on one. Ew. Like, oh, I love the N64 days. His fucking teeth. Okay. Is there going to be a boss here? Are there bosses in this game? I don't remember. I assume like a T-Rex is a boss or something. Oh, there's the hub. So we got to the place we needed. So I guess this was the baby area. Baby tutorial spot. So I think after this I'm going to render part one of Turok. I edited the first part, I put it together. And then I think render it. I'm gonna play some Darkest Dungeon, might grant some characters. I had a save slot right here. Nice. I'm gonna double save just to make sure. Yeah, so I can play some Darkest Dungeon, watch some stuff at the same time. Access to level 8. Confrontation. How do I put my keys in? Where's level 2? Because I have a couple keys for level 2, and I think some for level 3. Is what it looked like. Oh, did I go to this? Level 4. Level 6. Treetop Village. Alright, some of these sound fun. Alright, so there's level 2. Level 7. The middle's level 8. Level 5. Catacombs. Oh, we get access to level 3 as well. Alright, so let's do level 2. Let's just go in order. Alright, this looks pretty similar to level 1. Portal's at the start, though. They're trying to hide stuff behind us. Looks like tortilla chips. Oh, we're pretty close to another life, too. When I restarted the game, I had 2 lives, for some reason. Oh, because I saved right before I jumped off like a dumbass. That's right. Boom! Oh, shit. What the hell? Okay. I forgot about this. This was in the training area. They have this... These things where... Like, platforms and stuff... erect when you're running around. Like, if you kill stuff. Okay, so far, holding 60 frames, not seeing any problems. Quality looks a little better. I basically upped my capture quality by 25%, but it does put more strain on my system. But I'm doing it not just for you guys, but for myself. I really want to upgrade and maximize my videos as best I can, which I've been talking about in a few series so far. Because for some reason, I had so many videos where no one told me that my quality was complete shit for a while. Like, Dark Souls 2 is an example. There's so much fuzziness in Dark Souls 2 because I didn't know about disabling the resample in Vegas, because Vegas tries to smooth over your FPS view, like, by default. And that makes it look like complete garbage a lot of the time. And no one told me that I had that going on. And it made a lot of blurry shit possible, and my video capture quality was really low. So there were a lot of spots that just looked disgusting after I rendered them, but I never, like, watched through my videos enough online. So that's something I started doing. But no one told me about it, so I guess that's okay. People were being nice. Did you? That's fatal. So I'm really trying to up my video quality just to... I mean, mostly for me. Just because I want to put out good, you know, good product, basically. And plus, I think it's always better for the... What? Where the fuck? Oh, you're over here. It's always better for the viewer, too. Some people don't have, like, a huge hard-on for graphics, but it needs to not look like complete garbage, you know? Oh, there's a lot of health up here, thank you, sir. So we could... Looks like it goes around. I'm gonna start trying to use the map more, too. Okay. So what are we at? 15 minutes recorded minus 4, so we're at 11 or so, maybe 10. I could... I don't know about that one. This looks like a secret. Oh, is this just a shortcut back? No, okay. You have a sword, so I don't know what the hell you plan to do over there. I hope this wasn't the way to go. I want to explore a bit more. Just kind of like turned the corner, saw this, had our gamer senses tingling. Is this Treetop Village? Oh shit. It's over here. These look like arrows. Is this like triple fire or something? 5 tech arrows? Okay. So I guess when you get the giant quiver, it's like 10 or something. So I guess you're supposed to snipe him. Cool though, you get rewarded for exploring. Like, you get an easier jump to this shit. Can I make that? Should I make that? There's a portal, fuck. I'm gonna miss. Oh, I got it! Okay. I'm gonna wait here for that portal. You know, let's look up here. So I don't know if that was the right thing to do, but we did it. We have enough arrows. Does this just go around? Did I just make my life harder by taking that jump? Yeah, I did. Okay, so there's... Let's wait for this portal again. So I don't know what that teleport does. Hopefully it brings you, like, back up here. There it is. Oh, there's a new one, too. Shit. Okay, we can go back if we need to. So we have to go forward. There's a big health in the middle. You know what? Screw this room, dude. You have these freaking things going around. You have to, like, make the jump to grab the health. I can't even pick up the health if I did grab it. So I'm just gonna grab the potato chips here, the tortillas. Yeah, that's pretty fucked up, dude. You have a big health, plus an instant fall. Like, an instant death fall plus health. Oh, shit. Oh, I guess we're doing this. I can go back this way, too, if I need to. Okay, this was just a nice little goodie room. So we were over there. Looks like there's some... I wish I could zoom in or something. I see some... It looks like something's like right there, right? Alright, hold on. I had to make sure that no one... There are no witnesses. Got some Metal Gear Solid level shit happening. Did... Okay. Apparently different portals appear. And that one just, like, spawned on me. Alright, this is just for little triangles, thankfully. See some shit happening, though. Let's take a minute to admire the stuff here. Like, is this supposed to be some kind of throwback to, like, Aztec Mayan or something? I can't really tell from here. I don't know. Like, I know I'm looking a little too deep for lore and stuff in this game, because it's been pretty cut and dry what to do. But it is fun to look at these things. That looks like it's gonna knock me pretty hard if it decides to hit me. So we can, hopefully this doesn't do any knockback. It's probably going to, in all honesty. Just knock me the fuck off. But actually, there's no instant death over here. Yep, just like I said. We can actually scout what that is too. It looks like a blue health, which we won't. We don't need that. Yeah. We could make the jump. So let's take one more look over here. Yeah, it's just blue health, so I don't need that really. I was gonna say, there should be some way to get platforms, it looks like. I can make that. Barely. They're going to different timings too. Looks like it's pretty safe to get on there. I wonder what kind of ammo that is. Guess we'll go for it. Box of bullets. Is that just for the handgun? Pick up another one of those. What the fuck are these? Are those all purple? Okay, I'd like to take the frickin' wall out of here this time. No more random portals. I wonder if you can just sit there and camp portals. And just keep getting different stuff. I like that though, that adds a little bit of variance to the game, which... Sometimes I don't like variance in my games. Because dumb shit happens. But then there are other times where having a little bit of variance is pretty nice. So yeah, we took the easy way by making... that ridiculous jump. Which is probably an easy jump, I don't know. I'm not an expert at this game. But it did seem to make our lives easier. So there's... we have a lot of explosive shells. I found some in that little circle room with the Chronoscepter shard when I was running back. So let's... okay, we have more purple ones up here. So it's like 20 extra things towards a life, which is pretty good. Which I'm completely fine with, having more lives. I'm trying to get to like another save point before I stop recording. Kind of thing, and then pick up there. Even if it's like halfway through a video. Because that way, I don't have to deal with a lot of the... shit. Can't make that? Okay. Yes, that way I don't have to deal with too much of the backtracking. Oh, we got lucky on that jump right there. Got these trees. This looks interesting. They're pretty cool still. They look like, I don't know, giant lollipops or something. Am I stuck? Okay, we got another dinosaur in there. It's very hard to play everything that I want to play. Damn. Just because I have like Darkest Dungeon, then I have this, and then I have Smite too. I need to play Smite with my friends because they do miss me. Every time I pop on, they're like, "Oh man, school's kicking your ass." It's like, yeah, it's partly that, and then partly I'm just enjoying my other shit so much. Oh shit. Like my other games. I mean, you can hold down the button and it keeps shooting, but I really like to do like individual shots just to make sure I'm on target kind of thing. Where am I? These houses. These are just straw houses. This game is so fun, but there's so much that's like, why? Like, it's Dinosaur Hunter, you're running around, they're like modern military people, like these guys have camo. And then, I don't know what's happening. Like, there's no continuity. Well, there are portals, so I guess the portals are the continuity. Because like, if you have portals to other dimensions and shit warping in and all that, I guess it makes sense that there's a... did I just, like, walk through that wall? Yeah, kinda. Yeah, it makes sense that there's random shit like that, so I guess we can... dive? It's a shell? Oh, shit. I guess we have to follow this. Again, the breadcrumb trail. Breadcrumb. I say that word correctly. I'm talking too fast sometimes. Is there anything they need? Anything here? What the fuck? Heard that bird or something. I'm trying not to get stuck either. There's nothing over there, it looks like, or there's some kind of invisible wall. Hopefully there's no fucking sea monsters. I hate water in games. And I blame two games for that. There was a Star Wars game where you played as Dash Rendar, and one of the levels was swim through a fucking sewer and fight some kind of like giant tentacle boss or whatever. And that made me stop playing that game because I was so scared of it. And then Super Mario 64, there was a ocean level. They had a sea serpent coming out of a dam. What is it? The damn sunken ship. And then finally, you had Banjo-Kazooie. Even though I did a blind run of that game, I did play up to Clanker's Cavern. That is where I stopped playing the game because I had to see fucking Clanker, and that scared the hell out of me. And so they just put scary shit in the water. I don't like it. I don't know why that keeps happening. Like, they can't just make water, you know, a nice experience. It's always like, oh, you move slower, you don't get half your weapons, kind of thing, and then shit attacks you, and the shit's always faster than you because it's in water and they're amphibious. Or whatever, they're aquatic, I should say. I start using these shells, man. Shit. Did you just drop? Nice. I don't think I can throw the individual grenades, or I haven't found out how to. I saw that there's a grenade launcher weapon, though, in my inventory thing. Am I just... Are you, like... Why can't I hit you? Why are you cheating? Just turn on the hacks, bro. Half of these are hitting him. I guess I have to jump up there. Is he an illusion? This is a serious question. Shotgun's got some range though. What the fuck am I getting? Large energy shell. Cell? Oh shit. Oh fuck! Alright, game's not fucking around anymore. It's starting to put hella dudes on me. Did I just instant kill the deer by knifing it? Shit. Oh fuck. Alright. Gloves came off. The game is done throwing just regular melee dudes at me. From long range, that I have all the time in the world to just pick them off. So that's instant death, it looks like. What is this, though? Is the question. Like, how the... I know I hit him once. I swear that I saw some, like... I saw that I did some red damage. Yeah. It sucks. So I guess we need the... Don't want this? Yeah, I kinda do. Like, I need a saber-toothed tiger. Every now and then, just wow. So we should be looking for a little checkpoint at some point. Like some kind of wrap-up. Oh, there's a save point here. Cool. Alright, so I'm gonna save here. This one's gonna be a little... You know, let's keep going, actually. Let's go for a couple more minutes. Let's hit the half-hour mark. And then I'll just kind of cut. Maybe I'll do one more. As always, because I'm always having fun. It's always hard to... It's always hard to, like, leave the game. Yeah, I'm taking a lot more damage this time, though. Like, these short corners with the raptors are a little more challenging than what we've been facing. We're getting shot by people, and then we have people cheating and not letting us shoot them when they're on top of shit. At least I'm starting to get a little more accurate with my stuff. It's a nice... It's a nice bonus to all this. Oh shit, okay. Just because, like, when I was doing the training mode of this game, I was missing horribly with all my arrows, and I thought I was just gonna have the most horrendous time. Oh, what the? Some fucking Dark Souls traps right there. Yeah, one in front that like distracts you, and then one behind you. Damn, we're still not under 100 HP though. Because we're still not able to pick up blue stuff. That is a huge looking portal. Maybe not, actually. I don't want it. Alright, we've done this one. Oh, but I could use this time now. So I'm not over 200 HP. Oh, what? I can't pick it up. Shit! Oh, it's a full heal. That was so scary. That just... Because I just froze, and it did so much damage. Okay. What's up? Oh, shit. Ow, ow, ow. These assault rifle dudes. So we can go two different ways. We can go under, or we can go up. I guess let's check out the cave, and we'll be done. Is this cave a secret area? It's not on the map. Oh, shit. There's that fucking noise again. Yeah, see, this isn't on the map. Maybe there's another Chronoscepter shard. It's like the last time we found a secret, that's what was in there. Oh! Fucking bugs! Oh, bugs! Bugs everywhere! Invasion! There's maybe a queen bug in here, I'm calling it. Okay, that can overheal us, it looks like. Did we get, like, a health upgrade by picking that thing up in the middle? I don't think so. Oh shit, I heard another one. Okay. I don't know what I'm gonna play after this. Maybe I should just do math homework. It's probably better. Did I not have an assault rifle? There it is. Does this use the same bullets as my... It looks like it does. So I guess, is it supposed to replace it? Fuck, why is this so loud? So I got an assault rifle, is there nothing else in here besides just that shit? I don't think so. Okay. Let's head out of here, I guess. And go the other way. Okay, it just... I like how it just immediately stopped. I mean, I could do that. If I really wanted to. Even if I wanted to. Skip it, though. I feel like this game replaced GeForce Gemini, basically, in what I wanted to play for Let's Plays coming up, just because this is another shooter game. It's probably more fun than that. I mean, this is more my style of game. I'm not huge on the Space Marine thing, which is, it's alright. Speaking of Space Marines, I never played Warhammer. I played D&D, but not Warhammer, so I'm wondering how fun Warhammer is. I don't know. I like the tabletop kind of games, traditional stuff. Surprisingly. Okay, you're not taking a lot of damage here. I was gonna say, I need to pull this. Yeah, see, it does. Okay. Oh, it's a burst fire. Okay, I like this a lot more now. I like burst fire guns. I don't know why either. It's just they're very satisfying to use. Because they have this combination of feeling like they do pretty good DPS. Oh shit, where the fuck from? Like, they feel like they do pretty good DPS, but then you still get the precision thing, like the precision shot. Just because you have more control over how much you're firing. So which... Fuck, man, which way? Your choices, that's a long climb, by the way. So I guess let's... Shit. Velociraptors. The respawning enemies makes it so you have to keep moving, which is actually pretty cool. See, like, why do I... You know what, fuck it. It's good. Yeah, see? I just wasted 6 bullets when I could use 3. Or 2. Fuck, I'm just getting picked off. From the back? There we go. I kind of want to play this game with a controller at some point. Maybe on my own time, kind of thing, because I do have a 360 controller I could plug in. Have we been here? Just to see how much harder it is, or easier, I don't know. I feel comfortable on controllers normally. Shit. There you go. Your Mega Man Buster Cannon. So I guess let's stop here. I'm probably going to do one more and take a little break. Next time, we're probably going to go up the... Probably going to turn around and climb up that thing. Because this looks more like the way to go. So thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys later.